Hare Krishna. So today we are going to discuss on the topic, what is the importance of our scriptures or the Vedic literatures. So what we see in every field, in case of science also, or in case of anything, if you want to know that subject, we need to take the help of a book. Like for example, in our plus one and plus two, there is a very famous book for physics called H.C. Verma. So we used to read from that book and used to gain some knowledge about physics. So now, to gain knowledge about God, we need some books. So that is our Vedic literatures. Now, God is a thing that is called Paramatma, or which is even greater than Atma. Now, there are five gross elements the material world is made up of. Earth, water, fire, air, ether, three subtle elements, mind, intelligence and false ego, and subtler than the subtle elements is the soul. So with none of our material equipments we can know about soul. Then what to speak of the super soul or Paramatma or Bhagwan? We cannot know him by our own endeavor. We need some book. So the reference we can take from Vedic literatures to know about God. Now, what the scriptures tell is very logical, that behind everything there is someone who has done that. Like in our lab experiments also, we can see, to do an experiment we need a lot of effort. Like in titration, we need great concentration and lot of effort to make that titration, and something goes here and there and everything is messed up. So this entropy or disorderness comes by random, and to do something creative we need to put our effort. So nothing comes by chance, and that is why we see that the term hard work is very much important for success. So success does not come automatically. Nothing creative happens automatically. It needs effort, sincere and conscious effort. So we can see the whole cosmic manifestation is working splendidly. All the planets are moving, sun, moon, everything is there, and the temperature of earth is just perfect, the distance from sun to earth is just perfect. If it was a little nearer to the sun, the temperature would be very high and life could not exist. If it was a little far, then the planet would freeze. So there are so many conditions which are perfect, perfectly designed. So behind all these designs there is a designer. It is obvious, nothing happens by chance. So Krishna is also telling in Bhagavad Gita, mayadhyakshena prakriti shuyate sa characharam hetu nanena kantaya jagat bi parivartate. Behind this material nature there is Krishna, under whose supervision this material nature is working. So the scriptures are basically the user manual given by God, because God has created this material world, so he has given us the scriptures also. And by reading the scriptures we can know that how this material world is made, what is the purpose, what I need to do, and all these informations. So with everything there comes a user manual. Like a washing machine, if we buy a new washing machine, the company provides a user manual, and everything is written about that machine in that user manual. If we follow that exactly, we will get the benefit and we will operate the machine perfectly. If we throw away the user manual and want to manipulate on our own, it may not work nicely, and it may also happen that the machine get devastated by our wrong input. So that we have already done to our lives. We are rejecting the scriptures like Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam from our life, and that is why we do not know what to do with our life, how to live in this world. There comes three types of proofs called Pratyaksha Praman, Anuman Praman and Shabda Praman. Pratyaksha Praman means by direct sense perception, by eyes, by ears and all our knowledge acquiring senses, nose, all these things. And Anuman Praman means that I am assuming or I am guessing, I am concocting something, mental speculation. And Shabda Praman is the author from authority, knowledge coming down from authority, like our college professors teach, that is called Sabda Praman. So in Pratyaksha and Anuman Praman, there is some problems. Our senses are imperfect. Our eyes cannot see beyond the visible range. Our ears cannot hear beyond the range of 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. So our senses are imperfect, so we cannot rely on direct sense perception. If a sound is coming from the other room, we may assume and we may guess about the sound, but in reality that may be different. And scientific theories, we see that they are changing. There are so many theories about the atomic structure, so many theories about the evolution. So why they are changing? And one theory is proposed, given a Nobel Prize. Another theory, proving the previous theory to be wrong, is given a Nobel Prize. So why this is happening? Because the scientific knowledge or Anuman Praman, it is not coming from the absolute truth. We are guessing. Science means we are posing some theory, and if it fails in some test cases, we form a new theory. So this is the process. That is why we see the theories are changing and going to a relative truth. But the knowledge of the Vedas is coming from the absolute truth, Krishna or Bhagavan. So this knowledge of Sabda Brahman is coming directly from Krishna through the disciplic successions of Guru Parampara to us. So that is why it is the most authentic source of knowledge. As a proof that why should we accept the scriptures, we can see that Srimad Bhagavatam was written about 5000 years ago. But in the third canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, embryology is perfectly explained. What happens to the embryo in the first night, what happens after a week, everything is explained, which we came to know recently by the help of medical science. So the results match exactly. There are so many predictions of the avatars or incarnations of the Supreme Lord, like incarnation of Buddha, Kali, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, where they will take birth, when they will take birth, what they will do. They are exactly matching. There are predictions in the 12th canto about the Kali Yuga, how Kali Yuga will advance and what calamities will be there. And it will be a very distressful condition. People will be short-lived and they will be disturbed by many diseases. So we are seeing the effects. And the minute details like diameter of the earth is also given in our scriptures. It is told that of the Bhumandala, the ninth part is called Bharatavarsha, and the ninth part of Bharatavarsha is called Bharatakhanda. Now the dimension of the Bharatavarsha is 9000 yojanas, and 1/9 of that is 1000 yojana. That is called Bharatakhanda. In our scriptures, the planet earth is named as Bharatakhanda. So now 1000 yojanas means 1000 into 12.8 kilometers. That comes around 12,800. So we know that that is the diameter of the earth. The radius of the earth is around 6,400, and double of that is 12,800. So there are many things like that. The map of the earth, how will the map of the earth look like? It is also given in our scriptures. The distance from sun to the earth, it is also given. So how can they measure about 5000 years ago? So it is not something that is not authentic. Because this knowledge is coming from directly from the Supreme Lord, it has to be perfect. So we are seeing the results. Some of the results we can match by the dint of our scientific advancements and equipments. But there are many things which we cannot verify. So that does not mean that scriptures are wrong. We can verify the scriptures according to our ability, according to our consciousness. Like an animal or dog, he cannot verify any line of the scriptures. But we are humans, we are given some higher intelligence, so we can understand some parts and we can verify that. But scriptures are beyond our intellectual understanding. They are predicting something that we cannot even know by our intelligence. So this is how scriptures are giving the holistic information about the universe. So in the scriptures, there is a lot of information about the God and what is our position. How can I establish a relationship with God? And there are many activities called devotional service. It is mentioned in the scriptures by which we can establish a relationship with God. So this process can be experimentally verified. Like the Rupa Goswami, one of our acharyas, he is one of the works is Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, that is called Nectar of Devotion. So the subtitle is called The Science of Devotional Service. So this devotional service is also a science. You need to do some experiments that are the procedures, and you will get the predicted result. Like you can establish the relationship with Krishna and you can realize God. So this is how, if we follow the footsteps mentioned in the scriptures, we can realize God very easily. So this is called in Bhagavad Gita, Rajavidya Rajagujisham Pavitram Idam Uttamam Pratyakshabhagamam Dharmam Shushukham Kartum Abhyam. We can realize, and it is very soothing experience to practice the devotional service. So the founder Acharya of ISKCON, Srila Prabhupada, wrote Bhagavad Gita as it is. He as it is presented what Krishna wanted to speak in Bhagavad Gita. As a result, we can see there are worldwide many devotees. They are reading Bhagavad Gita and they are becoming devotees. So we can see if scriptures are presented as it is, they can transform our lives. And they are also getting taste in this devotional service. And they are becoming more enthusiastic to practice devotional service. And among all these Vedic literatures, all scriptures, this was written by Vyasadeva. And as a commentary to all the Vedic literatures, Vyasadeva compiled Srimad Bhagavatam or Bhagavat Puran, which is called the essence of all the scriptures. Nigamakalpa tarur galitam phalam sukham khad amrita dravasham yutam pivata bhagavata rasamalayam hura horasika bhubi bhavukah. So this is the essence of the Vedas. This is the mature fruit of the desired tree of Vedas. And it is also said that Nimnaganam jatha ganga devanam achyuta jatha vaishnavanam jatha shambhu purananam idam tatha. So this Bhagavat Puran is best among all the Puranas and all Vedic literatures. So thus we can read these great literatures like Srimad Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita, and we can gain the authentic information about the Supreme Personality of Godhead and make our life successful. Thank you. Hare Krishna.